ever cross your mind, you'll be interested in the work of Dr. Mike Bradley. Dr. Bradley is a psychologist, father of two, an author whose books examine the conflicts in teen-parent relationships. Well, this first book, yes, your teen is crazy. Loving your kid without losing your mind. He didn't take sides by reaching out to frustrated parents. But later, he balanced the score with yes, your parents are crazy, a teen survival guide. A title suggesting that the difficulties between teens and parents are not one-sided. I'm gonna pause right there and underline the difficulties between teens and parents are not one-sided. So it seems like there's just not like the parents are always right or the kid is always right. He says, it's important for parents and teenagers to realize that each contributes to what works well in a family and what goes poorly in a family. He explained why I see teen energy in the first issue. Read on to find out why it's sometimes hard to have the same relationship with your parents. Why see teen? Why do parents and teens often have a harder time being along than parents and younger children? Dr. Bradley. Teenagers are very close to becoming adults with different views than their parents. The problem is that parents forget teenagers are no longer little kids. And sometimes we have a hard time giving teenagers the space to be who they are becoming. Sequence is a question of transition for both the parents and the teenager. I'm gonna pause right there and circle. Teenagers are very close to becoming adults with different views. And then point an arrow to where it says, it's a question of transition for both the parents and the teenager. So it seems that teenagers are going through a lot of changes, and parents will always kind of look at kids, maybe at little kids, and so this transition can be hard for them to get used to. For example, a teen might start to think that their parents' religion is not for them. They're just being honest when they say, I don't want to go to your church or temple anymore. They don't think they're being disrespectful, but they need to understand that for the parent, this can be really shocking because they're used to their child doing what they say. I'm going to underline that. They're used to their child doing what they say. And write a question mark with asking myself, so what happens when child doesn't do what they say? It can be difficult sometimes when you're used to things a certain way and then all of a sudden it's totally different. So trying to understand how parents might be feeling when child doesn't. That's one of 100 problems that occur when teenagers become unique human beings. It's important for teens to give parents space to talk it out and recover. Talk it out. So that seems like that might be a piece of advice they've already given us. Why is he teen? Do all parents want what's best for their kids, or have you seen some who don't? I've seen some parents who don't care enough to have appropriate conflicts with their kids. Teenagers don't always see that when their parents say no, that takes a lot of energy for a parent. It's not fun having to fight with your teenager. A lot of parents think that their main job is to be a friend. So they're afraid to have a conflict with their child, to say no, that's something that could be dangerous. It's easier to say, I don't care what you do. But that's not really love. Loving someone means you love them enough to have them hate you because you love the person more than your relationship. That seems to be an important point that he's making about love between parents and teenagers. Loving someone means you love them enough to have them hate you, because you love the person more than the relationship. So this makes me think back to Greg and his father. Even though he's lecturing him and not letting him play basketball, it could just be because he loves him and actually wants, instead of wanting Greg to just like him, he wants him to actually do well in school. And you flip the page to 21. And you see this when parents refuse to let things do things that could end their lives, and kids feel extreme anger. So we're going to pause at that very end of paragraph 9. When I say go, silently and independently, think for 30 seconds about these two questions on the board. You read the first one, we'll go.
What do you think of any idea of what you have to do? Why?
And the second one, Leslie? So flipping over your handout from where we did the do now, on the back. You'll see there's a graphic organizer with a big bubble at the top that says main idea. In that bubble, you'll write down what you think the main idea is. In here, on this square, a piece of text evidence that supports this main idea. So first, just think to yourself what the main idea could be, skimming through the text and just write. Well, I was writing down a piece of text evidence. Take another 20 seconds, so just keep locating that evidence, and then we're going to talk as a whole class. Parents are crazy. Where did you get that idea from? The title. Tap your nose if you agree that the main idea is that parents are crazy. Okay. So I see you didn't tap your nose, Lizzie. Do you disagree? Sorry, can you speak up? Different. I saw you wrote on your handout too that you think it's about how parents are with their children. So, Lavelle, do you think the main idea is more about parents themselves being crazy, or do you think it's more about how they interact with their kids? How come? All right, where is something in the text that tells us about how parents usually interact with their kids? Sharina. You're jotting down the details, but at the moment, we're having a discussion, so make it happen.
You all want to get your thoughts in.
Pointed out that it could be because teenagers are becoming different people, so this could make it more.
Okay.